वेलकम बैक डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज शालिनी मिश्रा, योर ओसी टीचर, गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 10 एंड द टाइटल ऑफ द चैप्टर इज इंटरनेशनल ट्रेड। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल विल टेक इंट्रोडक्टरी पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इंटरनेशनल ट्रेड इज रेफर्ड टू एज द एक्सचेंज और ट्रेड ऑफ गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज बिटवीन डिफरेंट नेशंस। द काइंड ऑफ ट्रेड कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट्स एंड इंक्रीज द वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमी। The most commonly traded commodities are television sets, clothes, machinery, capital goods, food and raw material, etc. International trade has increased exceptionally that includes services such as foreign transportation, travel and tourism, banking, warehousing, communication, advertising and distribution and advertising. Other equally important developments are the increase in foreign investments and production of foreign goods and services in an international country. Now let's understand the concept of international trade. International trade consists of transactions that are devised and carried out across national borders to satisfy the objectives of individuals, companies, and organizations. The economic system of exchanging goods and services conducted between individuals and businesses in multiple countries. The specific entities such as MNCs and international business companies which engage in business between multiple countries are included in international trade. About 15% of the world's output is traded in international markets in a typical year. While the importance of the international sector varies enormously from country to country, the volume of international trade has increased substantially in past few decades. Now, we can say that purchase, sale or exchange of goods and services across national borders is called as international trade. Now, let's study some importance of international trade. First is benefits of division of labor and specialization. Division of labor contributes to the development of skill to a great extent because with the repetition of the same type of work, he becomes well versed and specialized in it. This specialization enables him to do the work in the best possible way, which improves his skill. Due to international trade, both the importing country as well as the exporting country get benefit of division of labor and specialization. International trade influences economic growth of a country. This increase also leads to the reduction of poverty level in various countries that come in contact with the international countries while international trade. Next is maximum utilization of resources. Some countries are naturally blessed with an abundance of raw materials. For example, Qatar for oil, Ireland for metals and fish, etc. Without international trade, these countries would never benefit from their natural resources or raw materials. Next is development of auxiliary services. The auxiliary services have developed commerce related services such as bank, insurance, warehouse, communication agency, etc. In international trade, these services increases and expanded in the countries due to import and export in international trade. Next is to maintain price stability. Easily available items of a country can be exported and to overcome price fall and highly demanding items can be imported to country the price hike, and this way the price level can be stable by means of international trade. Next point is high standard of living. Due to greater choices for consumers, more international trade results in more choices of the products. This leads to the higher standard of living. Next point is exchange of culture, fashion and knowledge. Different countries come in contact with one another by means of international trade and get information about one another and exchange their culture and customs by the medium of international trade and understand one another's rituals and culture so that international cooperation and harmony can be maintained over a period of time. Thus, culture, fashion and knowledge are exchanged among different countries by the medium of international trade. Next point is helpful in calamities. International trade gains more importance whenever there is disruption in supply of goods due to man-made or natural disasters and calamities such as drought, earthquake, epidemic, cyclone, etc. In country like India, agriculture mainly depends upon rain. Agriculture fails when there is inadequate rainfall. In such condition, grains can be imported and the natural calamity like drought can be overcome. Next point is world as a market. In international trade, the whole world is a market. Industrially developed and prosperous nations are using superior technology and produce things on large scale. They are also trying to find out the potential market for surplus production. International trade influences the economic growth of a country. This increase also leads to the reduction of poverty level in underdeveloped countries. Dear students, just go through the video and revise the topic. In next video, we'll discuss the next topic, that is incentives for export trade. Thank you.